To say that JR is shocked that Annie was his life-saving donor would be an enormous understatement. And on All My Children this week, rather than showing his gratitude to Annie in a normal human way, JR decides to pay her back the Chandler way, namely by starting a new plot against her. And it starts with him moving back home and buttering her up. Any guesses as to what he's up to? Annie may not be around for long, though, because Adam's hanging out with Brooke so much and not telling Annie how awesome she is every 5 seconds, so she starts to get bitchy and paranoid. Annie makes a beeline to Liza and wants to know what legal protection she has if Adam leaves her. Next thing we know, Annie's got divorce papers drawn up but doesn't plan on using them. That doesn't mean Colby won't. Uh-oh. After Tad breaks up with her following her whole reaction to that Damon is my son thing, Lady Lawyer Liza goes rogue. First, she starts drinking with Damon. Then she gets a new partner in crime, sorry, client, David Hayward. Not good. All that plus Randy warns Ryan about Madison, and Jack lets Erica know he's sticking around. She may be one of the reasons. This week on One Life to Live, Allison Perkins steps up Mitch's campaign of crazy when she kidnaps baby Sierra Rose. Skyler needs to find the baby, but Mitch has something else in mind. He wants Skyler to break him out of jail. Meanwhile, Roxy finds out about the abduction, but she can't say anything on account of her terrible secret. You know Roxy, she's got such a good poker face, right? Also, Kelly gets this mysterious phone call about her mother's mysterious death. Todd offers to help her get to the bottom of it, but Kelly just wants to take it right to the prophet's mouth. Yeah, Kelly's headed to Statesville to meet Mitch. Meanwhile, Cole finds out about Hannah's past with Ford, but will keeping Hannah's secret mean messing things up between Cole and Star? You know we hope not, but it looks like Star's about to have a secret of her own to keep. Something about Langston and a certain constantly shirtless college professor? All this plus Marty passes out, Jessica decides woodworking is key to Christian's heart, and Destiny and Danielle decide to go all High School Musical on us. This week on General Hospital, Ethan tries to plead his case with Christina and get her to admit he didn't attack her, but all that gets him is thrown in jail. On the bright side, both Carly and Jason start to suspect that Christina's not telling the truth. Of course, that doesn't exactly win them any fans. A Carly-Alexis blowout fight is in our near future. And speaking of which, how about Sonny and Luke? The former best friends have a huge fight when Luke suggests Christina might be lying. It'll be worth the price of admission alone to see these two Emmy-winning giants go toe-to-toe. Meanwhile, Maxie's heart just gets weaker and weaker. By the end of the week, she's on death's door. That's the bad news. Okay, that's the really bad news. But the good news is that we get an appearance from Maxie's late sister, Georgie. The question is whether Georgie shows up to keep Maxie strong or to usher her to the other side. All that plus Claire uses her sneaky lawyer tricks to get Dante to implicate Michael, and Lulu and Dante embark upon their latest episode of The Quest for Sex. Who, oh who, will interrupt them this time? Maybe no one?